Now we'll solve radical equations that contain more than one radical. And the steps for solving these types of equations are a little bit different than solving when there's just one radical. To solve an equation containing two radicals, we'll put one radical on each side of the equation, and then we'll raise both sides of the equation to the power of the index. And when we do this, sometimes this will eliminate the radicals and sometimes it won't. If a radical still remains, we'll isolate the radical on one side of the equation and raise both sides of the equation to the power of the index again, then solve the resulting equation and check our solutions. So for our first example, notice how we have two square roots both containing the variable x. So we want to put one radical on each side of the equation, which has already been done for us, and now we'll raise both sides of the equation to the power of the index, and since these are both square roots, we're going to square both sides of the equation. So when we square the square root of 2x plus 9, this will simplify to 2x plus 9. And on the right side, we need to be a little careful here. We're going to square 2, which would be 4. And then when we square the square root of x, that would just give us x. And since this equation does not contain a radical, we'll go ahead and solve for x now. Let's go ahead and subtract 2x on both sides of the equation. This would be 9 equals 2x, divide both sides by 2, and we have x equals 9 halves, which we would normally write like this. Now we want to make sure this solution actually works, so we'll go ahead and substitute 9 halves for x into the original equation. So we'd have the square root of 2 times x, which is 9 halves. So we'll go ahead and put this 2 over 1. Then we'll have plus 9 equals 2 times the square root of 9 halves. Well, this 2 over 2 simplifies nicely. So on the left, we have the square root of 18 equals 2 times the square root of 9 halves. Now for this, it's not easy to tell if these are equal to each other. So there's a couple of ways of doing this. We could check this on our calculator. Let's go ahead and start by doing that. So second x squared 18, close parenthesis, enter. And then we'll type in 2 second x squared for square root, 9 divided by 2, close parenthesis, press enter. And we can see they are equal, so the solution is x equals 9 halves. If we wanted to check these by hand, we'd have to simplify the square root of 18, which we can write as the square root of 9 times 2. So that's equal to 3 square root 2. And then on the right side, this is equal to 2 times the square root of 9 over the square root of 2. And the square root of 9 is equal to 3, so we have 6 over the square root of 2. And then if we rationalize the denominator, we would have 6 square root 2 all over 2. And 6 over 2 is equal to 3. So we'd have 3 square root 2 equals 3 square root 2, and it does check. Let's take a look at our second example on the next page. Again, we have two square roots, both containing the variable x. So notice how we have one square root on both sides of the equation, and because they're square roots, we'll square both sides. So on the left side, we just have 4x plus 9. And on the right side, we have negative 2x plus 24. Notice how this eliminated the square roots, so now we'll solve for x. So we'll go ahead and add 2x to both sides of the equation. And at the same time, let's go ahead and subtract 9 on both sides of the equation. So on the left side, this would be 6x, this is 0, equals, this is 0, and 24 minus 9 is equal to 15. Divide both sides by 6, and we have x equals 15 sixths, and these do share a common factor of 3. So we have x equals 15 sixths, but 15 is equal to 5 times 3, and 6 is equal to 2 times 3, so this simplifies to x equals 5 halves. Again, let's go ahead and perform substitution into the equation to make sure it actually works. So we're going to have the square root of 4 times 5 halves plus 9 equals the square root of negative 2 times 5 halves plus 24. We can write this 4 as 4 over 1. The 2 and the 4 simplify. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 2 2s and 4. So this ends up being the square root of 10 plus 9, that's 19. And on the right side, again, we can think of this as negative 2 over 1. The 2 simplify out. So we have the square root of negative 5 plus 24, which is equal to 19. So this also checks. Therefore, our solution is x equals 5 halves. I hope you found this helpful.